Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1 diabetes. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, how would I know if I have pre-diabetes? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning and tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. One of the most difficult aspects of knowing if you have prediabetes is that there really are no symptoms to speak of. If you have a cold, you know by the coughing, fever, congestion, etc. Those are the symptoms. But when it comes to prediabetes, there really are no concrete symptoms like there is for type 2. Chances are, if you have the symptoms of type 2, then you have moved past prediabetes to the type 2 stage already. But if you feel you're at risk for or want to know, your healthcare provider has options in testing for prediabetes. Doctors generally use one of three different blood tests to diagnose diabetes and prediabetes. One is called the fasting plasma glucose test, in which a person's blood glucose level is measured first thing in the morning before breakfast. The normal fasting blood glucose level is below 100. A person with prediabetes has a fasting blood glucose level between 100 and 125. If the fasting blood glucose level is 126 or above, then you're considered to have diabetes. A second test used in the diagnosis of diabetes is the oral glucose tolerance test, although this test is no longer commonly used as in the past. This test may be used to diagnose gestational diabetes in pregnant women. But in this test, a person's blood glucose is measured in the morning after fasting overnight and again 2 hours after drinking a glucose-rich beverage. The normal value for blood glucose is below 140 2 hours after the drink. In prediabetes, the 2-hour blood glucose is 140 to 199. If 2-hour blood glucose rises to 200 or above, then that's diabetes. My guess would be the most common test used today to diagnose prediabetes is the A1C test. The A1C, or hemoglobin A1C level, is another blood test that measures how much glucose has been sticking to hemoglobin during the past 3 to 4 months. Hemoglobin is the substance in the red blood cells that carries oxygen to the cells of the body. The A1C test is important in diabetes and prediabetes as a measure of the glucose control during the prior 3 months. Normal values for the hemoglobin A1C are 5.6% or below. Values between 5.7 and 6.4% are considered to reflect prediabetes, while values of 6.5% and over are typical for diabetes. Don't hesitate to ask your doctor about these tests. Some research shows that most people who have prediabetes don't even know they have it. Be proactive. Be tested as soon as possible. Don't forget to get my new ebook and please subscribe to our channel so that we can bring you many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.